Hello students, lecture 14. Today in lecture 14 we will discuss 3-4 articles, small articles, that is sense of collective belongingness or the idea of collective belongingness in India, the concept of Bharat Mata, images of Bharat Mata, Swadeshi and Swaraj flags and Quit India movement. So let us start about the idea of collective belongingness. Idea of collective belongingness means in what way the people were brought together, what methods were used by Indian revolutionaries. So it is also described in point form. So point number one, the nationalism spread when people begin to believe that they all are of the same nation. So nation was used for collective belongingness when they discover some unity that binds them together. Sense of collective belongingness also came partly through the experience of united struggle, that people are struggling together for freedom. Third, there was also a variety of cultural processes through which nationalism captured people's imaginations, history and fiction, folklore and songs, popular prints played a very important role in bringing nationalism in people in India. Next, the identity of the nation is often symbolized in a figure or image, as in case of France we discussed, and as in case of Germany we discussed. Similarly, in India, this helps in creating an image with which people can identify nation. In 20th century, with the growth of nationalism, that the identity of India came to be visually associated with the images of Bharat Mata. The ideas of nationalism also developed through a movement to revive Indian folklore. In late 19th century, nationalists began recording folk tales sung by bards, and they traveled village to village to gather folk songs and legends. Another way of creating a feeling of nationalism was through reinterpretation of history. History was also used. By the end of 19th century, many Indians thought that to instill a sense of pride in the nation, Indian history to be thought very differently. That in the past, we were independent, our culture, our natural heritage, all these were of the quality level, which were spoiled by outside rulers, the Britishers. So this was all about the sense of collective belongingness. The tricolor flag, image of Bharat Mata, nations, united struggles, folk tales, folk songs, folklore, history, all these were used to create a sense of collective belongingness in brief. Next is the idea of Bharat Mata or the images of Bharat Mata. The image of Bharat Mata was first created by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. It is important for one mark also. Later it was included in his novel Anandmath and widely sung during Swadeshi movement in Bengal. Moved by Swadeshi movement, Abanindranath Tagore painted his famous image of Bharat Mata, and in this painting of Bharat Mata is portrayed as an ascetic figure, pious, religious. She is calm, composed, divine and spiritual. These are described as the characteristics of the Bharat Mata. In subsequent years, the image of Bharat Mata acquired many different forms, as it was circulated in popular prints, in books and other media, was painted by different artists like Raja Ravi Verma. So this was the idea of Bharat Mata. Next is the Swadeshi flag and the Swaraj flag. During Swadeshi movement in Bengal, a tricolor flag was designed. It had three colors, red, green and yellow. It had eight lotuses, which represented eight provinces of British India, and a crescent moon representing Hindus and Muslims unity. And it was designed by Bengali revolutionaries, and the flag was used in Bengali revolutions. Next is the Swaraj flag. Swaraj flag was designed by Mahatma Gandhi in 1921. As Gandhiji always talked about Swaraj, so Gandhiji designed Swaraj flag in 1921. It was again a tricolor with red, green and white. Swadeshi was red, green and yellow. But in Gandhi's Swaraj flag, yellow was replaced by white. It had a spinning wheel in the center, representing the Gandhian ideal of self-help. The flag was carried by freedom fighters in marches and became a symbol of defiance, disobedience, that people carry this flag and they will disobey the Britishers' flag or the buildings. So this was all about Swaraj flag. Generally, question is asked comparison between Swadeshi flag and Swaraj flag. MCQs are also asked. So these are important for that point of view. Last article of this chapter is Quit India Movement. It is latest added in your book, in the last article given in the box. After the failure of Cripps Mission and the effects of World War II created widespread anger in India. Cripps Mission failed and World War II also created a situation of Quit India Movement. In such a situation, Mahatma Gandhi launched a movement calling for a complete withdrawal of British from India, that is Quit India Movement. On 8 August 1942 in Bombay, the All India Congress Committee passed the resolution for a non-violent mass struggle throughout the country. 8 August 1942, the Quit India Movement was launched. It was on the occasion Mahatma Gandhi delivered the famous speech, "Do or Die." Mahatma Gandhi used these words, "Do or Die," in the speech delivered before the Quit India Movement. This movement was truly a mass movement. In large number, people from all over India participated, which brought large section of society like students, peasants, workers, women and everybody. It saw the active participation of leaders, namely Jayaprakash, Aruna Asaf Ali, Ram Manohar Lohia and many women such as Matangini Hazara in Bengal, Kanaklata Barua from Assam and Rama Devi in Odisha. These were the women leaders who led large section of women to take part in Quit India Movement. Now we come to the map part of this chapter. So I revise, there are hardly 9-10 features from this chapter which are important for map work. First one is 1917 Champaran Satyagraha Movement against indigo plantation. Next is 1917 Kheda Satyagraha Movement against crop taxes and land revenue. 1918 Ahmedabad Satyagraha Movement in support of cotton mill workers. 1919 Jallianwala Bagh Incidents, Amritsar, Punjab. 1920 September Kolkata Congress Session. 1920 December Nagpur session, Nagpur Congress session held in Nagpur. 1922 Chauri Chaura incidents due to which Mahatma Gandhi decided to call off non-cooperation movement. 1927 Congress session, Madras. And 1931, that is Dandi coastal town, salt satyagraha or the salt movement. As per syllabus, these are the map features, and definitely two are asked out of these nine map features. So it is very important and easy, and these are only for identification. So you have to go through the map. Thank you very much. In next lecture, we will discuss the summary of the chapter, and so keep on watching and all the best.